and so that they would be able to take part. I mean, there's a station, as a example, I'm a patron. If I have a real store, I can train a lot of people on how to make money to become business person. And then you were before with the
Philippine
Coast Guard, so I'm sure you've trained a lot of people on how to become effective.
Yes, to become effective leaders,
effective leaders,
and to become a productive member of the society.
Right. So it's not always that you have to have a lot of money to be able to serve Rotary. In fact, just to be able to share your vocation, talk it out for free, train those people who need advices and guidance, because the future of tomorrow are the children of today.
Yes.
So if they are guided, motivated, or are inspired by people like us who are in the profession that we're into right now, I'm sure they look up to that and say, I would like to be like Hippy Daddy in the future. And so there are many other ways that we can do together, right?
Yes, yes.
So maybe we could also talk about the medical mission that we did recently in the Paranaque area, right? You're part of that.
Yeah, I'm not part of that, but all the charter presidents now will be hosting the medical caravan.
Yes.
Will be going all over the district of the
Philippine Health. So this
district
is called Makati,
Paranaque,
Pasig, Rizal,
Paranaque, Las Piñas, and Muntinlupa.
Muntinlupa and Palawan.
And Palawan, okay.
Right. So we will do caravan?
There will be many legs. The first leg is going to Muntinlupa.
Okay.
On September 26th.
September 26th. Yes. So where in Muntinlupa are we going to be?
It will be held at the sports complex of Tunasan.
Tunasan Sports Complex.
Yeah. So all the 9 clubs are allotted 50 patients each.
50
and
patients.
They will be given free medical and dental service.
Well, that's good.
Yes.
Like in Paranaque, sometime August 15, we have one big event also. We did it in Better Living in El Dorado. We did the dental, surgical, even surgical. Our doctors from the World Community Hospital, Dr. Fogler, they conducted the surgical mission. So there were about 12 patients who were operated of their cysts and minor cysts.
Yeah.
Mabukol, they call it. No? So on the spot. And also we have legal advisors. There's somebody from the lawyers. We have a lawyer, of course. Free legal services. So it's very interesting to know, like, these people are very much deprived, especially the depressed area, no? They're very much deprived of those opportunities. So it's to go together as sharing our vocation, and then we can really touch the lives of people.
Yes, that's right. And I'd like to say that the public should see now the effectiveness and the role that Rotary International is doing to our community.
Mm-hmm.
We are not here to get the role of the government. We are here to complement and assist the government and help our fellow men improve their living condition.
Mm-hmm.
And this is being done on voluntary basis by the members of the Rotary Club. And they do it out of love.
Right, out of love.
Yes.
Because, again, God's commandment is in love, we share. Okay, to end the portion of the day, Chippy Daddy, before I thank you, some words of wisdom. In Matthew 5:16, God commanded that we let our light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise our Father in heaven. Let it be the light of the world and the city on a hill as we serve above self. That's our Rotary's motto. It's also very biblical, no? Let us acknowledge the goodness of God in our lives. And of course, as God is blessing us, we should share our blessings to others also.
Okay.
So with that, our time has ended, and I thank you very much. Do you have any word of wisdom?
Thank you also for this opportunity. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
God bless.
Yeah.
Cheers to Rotary.
Yes, yes.
And we pray for the best for our September 10th Literacy Summit.
Yes.
Ada.
At the Aerospace Museum at the Baltimore Air Base on September 10th,
Thursday,
from 12 to 4 in the afternoon.
We have guests who are very, very good to talk about doing all these things, literacy projects for the youth.
Okay,
so with that again, thank you very much for being
you.
Here. It's my pleasure to have you here. And thank you so much again. God bless. God bless you.